In this video, I'm gonna show you a simple way to create a procedural edgewear mask in Blender, so you can give your materials a degraded and more realistic look. It's really cool because you can control the spread of the edgewear, and you can use it with many different materials. I'm using Blender 4.0 in this tutorial, so if you're using a different version of Blender, the layout can be a bit different, but if you have any problems trying to find something that I'll show you, just let me know in the comments and I'll try to help you out. So without any further ado, let's get started. I'm gonna use this barrel to see the result we are getting. I got it from polyhaven.com, and I'm gonna leave the link in the description in case you wanna download it. First, make sure you have the Node Wrangler add-on enabled, because it has useful shortcuts for dealing with nodes. Now, let's add a new material. I'm gonna rename it to barrel. Add a bevel node. Press Ctrl+Shift+L+ to preview the node result. The bevel node essentially gives us the normal information of the object, but when we increase the radius value, it smooths out the edges, and you're gonna use this to detect where the edges are. I'm gonna increase the samples to get a better result. More samples give more accurate results, but it's also slower to render. 4 is usually fine, I just want it to look better, but you don't need to change it if you don't want to. Now let's add a texture coordinate node. And I'm gonna use a vector math node to calculate the dot product of the normal information of these two nodes, and this is gonna give us our edgewear mask. We're gonna use the normal information from the texture coordinate and bevel nodes as inputs for the vector math node, and we need to change it to dot product. Now I'm gonna add a map range node here to create more contrast. I could use a color ramp instead. It would do essentially the same thing, but in this case, I prefer the map range because I can type in values instead of using sliders. So I think I have a bit more control, but if you prefer the color ramp, feel free to use it. I'm gonna increase the from minimum value, and it should be slightly smaller than the from maximum value. I'm gonna invert these two values. Alright, we're getting there. I'm gonna increase the 2 minimum value to make the white areas even more white, so we get a stronger wear effect in our final result. Just let me show you how to do it using the color ramp instead of the map range node, just in case you don't know how the map range node works, and in case you prefer to use the color ramp. You just need to invert the sliders, and the white one should be really close to the black one, similar to what we did to the map range node values. So as you can see, we have basically the same result. The color ramp is a bit darker, but you just need to play around with the values to get the result you want. I just think that in this case, it's easier to get the result I want with the map range node. Alright, so let me delete the color ramp, because I'm not gonna use it here. And now we can use the radius of the bevel node to control the spread of the edgewear. Alright, this is basically how we create the mask. But to make things a bit more interesting, let's add more details to the mask. I'm gonna delete the principal BSDF, because we're not gonna use it. Now we need to add a texture to create some variation. I'm using a noise texture, but you can use a scratch mask or whatever you think is gonna work for you. Plug the factor into the radius of the bevel node. I will also use a color ramp here to get more control over the noise texture. I'm gonna drag the sliders to get a result that I'm happy with. Alright, there we go. Add a math node here. Set it to multiply. I'm gonna increase the detail of the noise texture. I'm gonna adjust the roughness a little bit as well. Now we can use the value of the math node to control the spread of the edgewear. I'm still not happy with this result. So let me see what I can do to make it look better. Okay, so let me increase this value. Alright, so let me see how it's working. Okay, so let me also adjust this color ramp here. Yeah, there we go. Looks better. And yeah, the mask is done. Now we can add a mix shader node and blend two shaders together using the mask as a factor. I'm gonna use these paint and rust shaders. This rusty metal, I actually have a tutorial showing how to create it. I'm gonna leave the link for the tutorial in the description of this video. This paint material is not too complicated. If you want me to create a tutorial on how to create it from scratch, just let me know in the comments. So I'm gonna add the mix shader node. I'm gonna plug the shaders into the mix shader. And I'm gonna use our mask as the factor. And Ctrl Shift left click to see the final result. I'm gonna select the nodes that correspond to the edgewear mask. And I'm gonna press Ctrl J to add a frame. And I'm gonna press F2 to add a label to it. Of course, there are other ways to create edgewear in Blender, but this method is actually my favorite. One last thing, it's important to mention that this setup works only in cycles. And if you enjoyed the video, consider subscribing to the channel because I'm always posting videos like this. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.